sweet. What am I doing? I'm playing Kerbal. Now things are in an appropriate spot. Except for my chair. Yeah. And my water bottle and probably everything else. Okay. Hopefully my internet will be stable. I played a lot of the science mode, whatever it's called. Yeah, there's a science mode. Sandbox is what I've done the most of. I've been playing some, I guess, single player, I mean, some of the non-streamy slash recordy science mode, and that's been interesting, because you don't get all the stuff at the beginning, which is, again, interesting. I get to try career mode, which is what I plan on doing here. What any of these symbols mean. I mean, I remembered prograde and retrograde, but these other ones are new. Radial and radial out, normal, anti-normal. I mean, I know what they are, but I forget what symbol means what. Alright, screen region, go away. It's 10:30 on a whatever day is it? On a Tuesday. Totally the best time to stream. Hello, Henry. Hello, David. What did you end up getting to eat, Henry? I must know. These are important. Or it's important that I know these things. I'm not sure if you've noticed, but every time you eat, I have to know. Hello, Gmail Hermit. I haven't seen you in a while either. I streamed like, last week, I think, but before that, I think it was a while. Hello, Larzor. Nice. On my tablet. Hello, Dr. Sketchbook. So maybe Tuesday at 10:30 actually is a really good time to stream. Kerbal Space Program has music now, but I have it turned off because it's, I don't know. I'm not that big of a fan of it. Maybe put something a little more. There we go. Something spacey. Alright, start a new... Oh, I try career mode. There are apparently difficulty options, but I'm gonna leave them all the same. And we've got flag choices here. I assume there's a way to add your own. For now, it would be nice and boring. Oh yeah, tangerine salad. Yeah, we picked up some. Or I guess I picked up some. Okay, so in this you get like contracts and stuff, right? Oh, here we go. I don't know what any of these do. Research and development. We have no science. This is the science mode. So we have basically no parts. We've got command pods, crappy engines. This is gonna be great. I'm gonna kill Jeb on the first. But when I have money now, what is this? I don't know what Kerbin money is, but. Launch a new vessel. Sounds like an acceptable mission. Oh, my mic is a bit quiet. I can fix that. We're gonna call this... Rootkit. Let me know if that's better. And I'm so gonna blow you up, Jeb. That's basically all the parts I start with. Gonna wanna not have parachute be on the same stage as everything else. It's a little quiet. Hopefully this is good enough. And let's hope the engine sounds aren't overpoweringly loud. What is this? My money. That's my mission. I don't know what those things are. Oh good, they're both gonna be exhausted at the same rate. If I break 5,000 meters with this, I will keep this around for the next mission. Still a bit quiet, but better. Okay. Because my apoapsis is gonna be here. 36 cam. Not too bad, Jeb. Thank you. Do I have enough control to direct this like back to the landing pad? Not really. And this is set to a reasonable. No, not you. The parachute. Yeah, that'll be fine. I feel like I should be part of more Do streams too, Dr. Sketchpad. In that there should be more of them. I don't think Jeb's gonna die. I think Jeb's gonna be okay. Another thing about KSP that I like is that there's only runways and rocket facilities. There's no curb in cities. It's literally that they only exist on the surface to make rockets. Okay, there's explosions, but Jeb made it. I got 5 science out of that. I actually somehow managed to reclaim parts. Oh, yes. So I think that counts as a mission. Alright. Not get it because I didn't. Okay. Stack decoupler R10. Do I have those? Is this the R10? That's the R10. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna test this in our mission. And I actually think I hit that with the rocket, so. Alright, Jeb, are you ready? That's what this thing is. I've always wondered, like, what is this for? Oh god, I am gonna beat 33. On brick 33. Oh, didn't break 33. That's gonna suck. Speed. Yep, just a little off. I think I know how to hit it, though. Assuming contracts are, you know, if I'm allowed to just launch until I get them, or if I need to make them on that mission or not, I don't know. Alright, same as before, engine's gonna blow out at the bottom. Yeah, now that's a landing. Mission control. I did just test it. Flying. Don't know what they mean by flying. Wait, did they mean an actual plane? Oh, I see. Alright. Now we'll probably soft land. This is now Rooket 2. Actually, the truth is that Kerbin is actually a much smaller planet, but what you see on the surface is actually compressed nose cone. So they have to spend their entire, in order to save their civilization, they must launch as many nose cones as possible in orbit. Going on. We still may not make it. How close do we get? Oh, we actually do worse. Speak backwards Spanish. I did not know that. See, now I think you're slow enough not to explode. I'll double check. I didn't think I had any staging tech, but I could have some. Virtually all the parts got recovered, so that's good. If I do, I think there was a mission for testing one of these. Yeah, let's take this one. I think they're under structure. Oh, okay. I do have a stack decoupler. Okay. Let's actually get these in a decent order of... We want the upper boosters up there, and we want the upper engine up there. Because this may get us high enough to test the booster mission. Where's our booster mission here? So we need to test the boosters flying at 1900 meters and from a speed of, okay, and oh, we'll see what we get with the decoupler. All right, wait, there's more I need to test with the, okay. This is now Rocket 3, Jeb's gonna die. Now, on my science tree playthrough, I have Jeb stranded in space, and I intend to rescue him at some point in the future. This ain't going so hot. Well, I'm going to hit the appropriate level of oh boy, I'm gonna hit the appropriate level of yeah, I've already hit the contract thing. Ooh, contract complete. Oh yeah, I got money and is that reputation? I think it's reputation. Look at Jeb, so happy. I don't know, but at least somewhat recently. It's only cosmetic at the moment, as far as I've read, but that may be old information. Can I see anything interesting? Can I see Demun? Nope. There's a chance it'll happen again as I start hitting the atmosphere more heavily. You gonna do it, Jeb? Jeb? There we go. Center. Hi, kitty. Let's recover our Rooket. Money. We've got the ability to orbit Kerbin. I don't have a rocket capable of doing that yet. Do I have a time? Oh, okay. This never expires. There's no reason not to accept it. Alright, do we have enough science to buy anything? Yes, we do. What does this give us? Fuel tanks. Fuel tanks, science, and couplers. And how much are these guys? Ooh, we're almost to those guys, too. A science package. Is this the same fuel tank I'm using? No, it's not. I'm not going to do crap. And we are going to need some science. Rooket 4. Alright. The science stuff I know of from the previous one, what you do is you click on it, you can observe the mystery goo, And see, I'm gonna get 3 science out of that, so if I keep this data and launch, you get different things out of it based on... No, I'm just using the boosters and not using them. Oh, and those are in the same stage? Let's revert this one. Because it didn't stage correctly. How about you don't be a dick, and you actually fire when you should? Let's go to our Apple Apsis here. And then observe the science goo. Science hasn't been science. The goo seems to have clumped into a sphere. It also appears brittle. Face my retrograde here. We may start to see the fire again soon. I think it usually happens as soon as you start hitting the around this zone, like 25-ish. Let's see what we get. Yeah. Wow, did this really just jump back to the song again? Actually, I like this song better. There may be some damage when this hits, but we'll see. carp. Because those capsules broke, they may not count for science when I recover them. Yeah. None of that science-scienced. This is totally gonna go well. Failure's never an option when Jeb is on the line. If it doesn't get damaged, oh, can I recover that debris? Let's actually check that. I don't think it counts as debris then, because it's not being tracked, I think. There's Rook at 4. Yeah, I don't think any of the debris counted. You on the ground. Cube data. For. Atmosphere, so let's check this mystery goo. And then we'll see how high up we get. And not as high as last time. Makes sense with our increased air resistance. Does this count as, yeah, I think this counts. Okay. Let's see, if you want to track along, you need to turn it on. Is that actually show up somewhere? Or is that, I don't want to install any mods, but if it's just a checkbox, that may be useful. Bursting into flames part. should be happening very soon. Or not. There we go. Okay, it's like 22 that it kicks in. Ah, so I may be able to recover that. That may help out in my science-y stuff, because, well, on my science research playthrough, or whatever you want to call it, there may be several containers of science just lying around. They explicitly say what temperature they're able to get up to. And I assume that will eventually be a factor. Pop at 500. Now we're gonna hit the ground like a delicate fucking flower. They're made out of 100% asbestos fibers. They landed really close to each other. And I will get some diminishing science out of these because they're very similar missions. I am doing contracts. Alright, now I've got a lot of science so that I can science some science here. Solid fuel booster will help me get to orbit. Parachute may be useful for a lot of this stuff, but nose cones. Actually, that decoupler may be useful as well. Did I get one in here? Have a good decoupler. Yeah. Alright, I've tapped out my science. Jeb, let's get you killed. I have a lot more stuff now. I should just build a new one from scratch. Obviously, we're going to need a Command Pod. Stack decoupler, radial decoupler. What number of chairs? This is Rook at 5. This is gonna be a disaster. Alright, let's do this, Jeb. Jeb gonna die. Alright, now that I have the contract open, let's see what we need to do with this booster. Like I finished something. This guy is, as expected, insufficient for, which one did I finish? Okay. Ooh, you get science for 2 contracts. Oh, I'm actually accelerating. I am going to run out of fuel before I reach an orbit, but oh well. Actually, I might actually make a full orbit. Ooh. Should be going inward. Jeb is totally gonna survive re-entry. In fact, I'm so confident of that, I'm gonna pop the parachutes now. That way I'm gonna orient this towards that. Hey, Geek Brigade. See, because this is going to decrease over time, as I drag through the atmosphere. I may end up doing more than one orbit, which is more than I expected. And this should be coming in way faster. Space Center is, I believe, somewhere over here. Yeah, I'm gonna land eventually. Let's keep myself oriented. I was wrong. It's greener there. Shoots are going. This is a very oblique angle. Time. Which means I should make sure that this guy pops a little bit higher. Because sometimes, sometimes the elevation on Kerbin is higher than. In fact, I'm going to do that for all of them. No, select the parachute, set its altitude. Oof. Okay, this'll do. So these would have deployed fine. There's my shadow. Oh, Yeah, you can change the altitude and you can also cut the parachute. I don't know what this one does. I think that might mean the atmospheric deploy pressure. Yeah, they would have deployed right about now, which would have been a bit close, I think. Yeah, because it looks like the altitude here is a good 300, 450-ish. Like a top. Center. No, I'm actually on Kerbin in contract mode. So right now I have a very limited set of let's reclaim him. Let's reclaim the object, which will have parts, and I think that may have counted as a contract. Oh, I have to have some of these things fly as well. I don't have enough components for that. I'm sorry, I have 25. Okay, well this is winglets and wing connectors and the jet cockpit. So this will probably be my next one. Yeah, this will probably be the next one. Well, after this one, obviously. And that's where more science is. Alright, let's see if some... the launch stabilizer assembly. Thank you. wants me to test something I don't have yet. Alright, there was something about testing the Separatron. We'll try that one next. Okay, test TT-18A. It just says it's in orbit, too. I totally kind of almost orbited Kerbin. Sake. We'll grab our decoupler, and I believe there was a different kind of decoupler we needed to test. The radial coupler, is this the 38? I don't have the T, whatever, 18. Supposed to go here. That needs to be tested flying. This needs to be tested orbiting. And I need to include an actual orbit, which I think I can do now. Fuel. Probably. And I think this might work. Which that's this giant booster. I'll get on top of that. Okay, this is gonna blow up. Rook it. Is this six? It's six now. Got some science on there. Crap, this is gonna blow up. The stages aren't right. It seems like sometimes the game gets into a spot where it stages perfectly, but sometimes it just does the stupidest shit ever. Like, why would I want... this doesn't even... No. You go at the beginning. And then you go there. No. You go here.
Thank you.
that? Is it just light hitting a mountain or something? Actually, I guess maybe I don't need to build a plane. Yeah, I was assuming that flying meant that it had to be a space plane, but it looks like, based on the status of this, that maybe it doesn't. See the craft. There we go. Some of these contracts may be a bit easier than I was imagining. Because I was thinking, it looks like a lot of the space plane parts aren't available until you do a lot of research. Atmosphere. I'm not sure if I've done any goo experiments here. None that matter. Well, if I get enough science, the next upgrade I can get the Staputnik probe core thingy. And that means I could test a lot of these things just by building one-off explosive, destructible pieces of crap. Shouldn't waste my electrical charges like that. This has a reaction wheel in it. And some monopropellant, actually. Correct. How much longer is this going to take? Okay. So I actually need to land with the LV-909 liquid fuel engine intact. So I will tackle them in order, I guess. Jeb. So I have time acceleration at its maximum. Gravity was good as a suspense movie. And extremely visually compelling. So this is reputation, this is Kerbin Dollars. If he was Sandra Bullock breathing heavily for 2 hours. Some people would like that. Let's see, for LV-909 you could have just done it on the launch without going a millimeter. Huh, I may try that. Are already deployed. I'm just going to go to this. Wait. I don't think that can happen. I don't think he's going to automatically land because I'm in the atmosphere. I don't think it calculates that appropriately, and I don't want to lose Jeb.
Oh.
Well, for the 909, I've already got the launching with it, I think. I think I've just always jettisoned it and used a different engine for the middle stages. Alright, we're actually hitting the atmosphere now, so this should be decreasing. He respawns. I didn't know that. In my I guess science mode, I have Jeb circling the sun, and I'm waiting until I have enough equipment that I can go and rescue him. Because I don't even have I think I may have just unlocked the 3-person command pod, so I can set it up with just one Kerbin and pull him down. But I don't have the chair yet. Okay, yeah, this will be the time it goes down. Again, worried about mountains. I'm going to set these to 1,000. Got our landing gear. Oh, yes. Oh, we're gonna hit the surface hard. Jeb, no! Okay, we were going too fast when the chute's deployed, and Jeb's dead. Jeb. There, I've got a flag. I assume I just lost some reputation there. Let's do some of these here in a safety way. Alright, so what engine was the first one here on the contracts? LV-909. can do it. You can get back in there. Yeah, whatever. It has been 0 days since... Yeah. Okay. Contract completed. So this, we need to test it. Actually, I'm gonna use the restroom. I will be right back. Alright. That did not take long. Mm-hmm. Do I have this T18A stability enhancer? I don't think I do. Said cancel. I have to wait for it to cancel. Sorry. Actually, this is Rookit -1. Maybe it should actually. What else do I need to do in a contract here? So that's the stability. Okay. T-45 engine. And I have to test it at a particular altitude. And I think we can accomplish that. Wasn't there something about a decoupler as well? Coupler, Mark 16 parachute, Separatron in orbit. Okay. We'll just put the maximum thrust engine there. Put something about the boosters. Which boosters do I need to boost here? We'll start with the big guys. Okay, and we will put you on there for stabilization. Rook at -1. Louch. Yeah, this is going to explode. This particular decoupler, the I guess the sideways one, the one that the boosters are attached to, I find doesn't have enough ejection force. So you end up just... Ooh, that was almost bad. Contract complete, oh yeah. Alright, so... this we need to test at 17,000 whatever. I just detached everything. Oh, and they're on the same whatever? Alright, once we hit 17, we're calling this. Okay. That was another staging issue, but I think we might be okay. We might be okay. What am I... I already tested at the speed. Why did you G speed? No, you already were at that speed. Whatevs. We can't see anything. Why would they ever put this in the same stage? Why is that an automatic staging setup? Okay. Wait, I did all those things. Yeah, all those things are met. Why aren't you dinging off? Launch the part through staging? You mean it has to go separately from my main vessel? That's weird. I don't think it said that, did it? I'll check it when I get back to the detail view. Bill's gonna make it. Okay. No, the engine was on the thing that I was on. I mean, it was attached to my craft. I'm gonna reread it and see what if they say anything weird about it. I mean, it was on my craft. Do I have to do that and then release it? Come on. Cover. Activate the part through the staging sequence when all... I don't know what they mean by activate the part through the staging sequence. Meaning, okay, I think I get it. I think it can't be active until I'm in that zone and then I turn it on. Okay. That makes some sense. Which means you piece of crap, need to be here. And I'm actually going to... during this thing that's easy. Let's see. Mark II parachute. Which one's the Mark II? Is it this one? These are very similar bits of data. Okay. Oh. Okay. All right, what do I need to do with these radial decouplers then? Or not stacked, radial decoupler. Okay. Yeah, that's not gonna happen. A little too slow. Alright, just a little too slow. Oh, here. And the parachute, I don't think I'm gonna be able to do this round. That's how we deal with being a little too slow. This time I'll actually have my SAS module on to start so I don't drift as easily. Contract complete. Science of money awarded. Oh yes. Okay. Stack decoupler should be able to do, and then radial decoupler. I'm gonna be going too fast for that, aren't I? Yeah. I may still hit the first surface too fast. I'm gonna land right back on top of the Space Center. Much to see in here. Look at the nav ball. Okay, Space Center. He's happier because he didn't die. Okay, yeah, I've noticed that there are some unknown objects that... I'm not sure if I can see any. Yeah, these thingies. But I can't target them as... as, like, interception targets, like planets. Is there a way to do that easily, or do I just have to sort of look around and gun it? I can research something, I think. like to get the probe core. Yeah, this will be good. That way I can create things without killing Kerbins. Wait, I was gonna look at, see if there's more. Space madness.
Oh.
Okay, that didn't make any new ones available. Okay, let's try this parachute one. They're counted as space parts. Give you a reaction wheel. All right, I need to test the R10 solid food booster at a particular height and the parachute at a particular height. So let's get a fuel canister. We're also going to attach one straight up on top. Okay. Space parts. Well, I've noticed that they seem to have sizes, but other than that, I've had actually relatively close flybys, but not enough to where I'd be able to see much, because they seem to be really small. Alright, so we need to test our stack decoupler. It doesn't even need anything attached to it. Okay, this one is actually higher up than the parachute. But at a wider velocity range. Wait, no, the radial decoupler, not the stack decoupler. Radial decoupler. Yeah, it's still at a higher altitude. And what does it need for the stack decoupler? Exploded. You should be here. Don't know. Find out. you can actually move. Can you crash them into things? Can you crash them into Kerbin? Can you crash them right onto the launch pad? All right, let's pull up my contracts menu here. Stick around. First one up is this guy. I assume they're like near, you know, near Kerbin asteroids, but I don't know if they all are. Parachute, I'm not gonna get. You don't have to be a book nerd to know what a vermicious canid is. They show up in the movie. Alright, am I going to be going too fast to test, Time acceleration. Whatever. Yes, kitty? Alright, I don't know if there's any recoverable parts. Recover. Science anymore? We've got 32. Okay, that gives us a lot more science. Wait, I should see if completing that contract made any more contracts. Engine. Go max, find the max of order, extract the rank, turban. Okay, so I gotta hit that. See if we have enough stuff to make a jet plane. I'm still gonna get somebody killed. Okay, I do have some aerodynamic parts. Way too heavy for planes. Oh, I don't have any landing gear either, do I? Okay. Don't have any pylons. Here we go. I really need some kind of I don't even have the crosshatch thingy. Goodbye, Bill. Contract complete. Strut connector is very useful. I have 70 science. Alright. They're one of my contracts here. Okay. The parachute. Actually, I didn't check to see if there were any more contracts. Okay. They want me to go up to 9K to activate it. Okay. Uh-huh. And that's the big guy, right? Alright, this may work. Okay, Rocco Max.